Alto, as well as the big storms that you know of, and Katrina and Harvey and a few others. In these racks, we've always kept two truckloads of food that's ready to disperse at any given time. And we did that a long time ago, a month ago, and it didn't go very far in this particular case. Storm clouds of COVID-19 pandemic were looming in January and started to really darken for us in March. And this is a storm like we've never seen before, because you really can't see the gone to some of those impacted areas and actually seen destruction, but this is really more of an economic destruction. Moreover, our food banks usually work together across regions to share resources, to shuttle resources, move resources. But this is a continental disaster. There are no resources to share or move, so our communities are really left on their own to create their own resources and use federal resources as they're available. A month ago, and authorized all of our staff who were not essential to supporting the physical production and delivery of emergency products to work remotely at home. Through organized efforts of Feeding Texas and our partner food banks, we began preparing special requests to the Texas Department of Emergency Management to include additional commodities and possibly National Guard support if needed. As part of this effort, we reached out to Judge Moran's office for a preliminary letter of support. The increasing social distancing measures soon took a toll on our regular volunteer attendance. With the closing of the schools, one of our close partners in an after-school programs, the Mentoring Alliance, came to our rescue by diverting their paid staff, of which they chose to stay to keep paying and to keep on staff, and their volunteer organizing efforts to help bolster our volunteer center. And they did a fantastic job, and that worked really well for a while. But as the stay-at-home orders
much, Brian, and thank you, Dennis, for those remarks earlier today. The thing I want to talk about as I begin this afternoon is to focus on two concepts, the concept of service and the concept of sacrifice. What you're seeing here today really is the nexus and the epitome of both of those, both service and sacrifice. You see in this room a number of National Guardsmen who have given a lot of sacrifice already before this week, but now to this community. These are members that of the National Guard that live in other areas of the state and beyond. Members that have come to this community who are now away from their families, who are providing help and assistance to our community. And for that, I'll tell you, gentlemen, we are thankful. We are appreciative that you have given of your time and of your service and of your energies and of your love for this community, one that you do not live in, most of you. One that now you are receiving a lot of appreciation from. Let me just tell you, we will not forget this. This is sacrifice on their part. But not just sacrifice on their part, but service, because this is a long-term service organization. The East Texas Food Bank has a wonderful mission, fighting hunger and feeding hope. When you talk about really narrowing down, what is this really all about? It's not just about hunger. It is really about hope. No child, no family should have to endure going hungry on a day-to-day basis. This organization existed before the coronavirus pandemic and will exist after the coronavirus pandemic. And it is essential to fighting hunger and feeding hope, not just in Smith County, but in all 26 communities. So for that, we are thankful. And we are appreciative of the leadership of the East Texas Food Bank from top to bottom. You heard from both the board member and the CEO. Dennis, you and your team and your staff and your board have done an outstanding job projecting the needs and practically meeting those needs during this crucial time, and doing so in a very timely basis. It is tough to get organized in a quick manner to ramp up and to feed this number of people in this amount of time. So we are appreciative of your efforts, and we know that long after this coronavirus pandemic ends, you're still going to be a vital part of our community. And we should support and continue to bless this ministry so that they can continue to bless those in East Texas. It is an act of collaboration. We've seen it throughout this community as this pandemic has rolled through, that we have a love for one another. We have talked about incessantly this love your neighbor concept. And it is true, because at the very base of what we're called to do in this life, it is to love God and to love others. This is, again, a great example of how we love our neighbors. Not just the one that lives next door, not just the one that is necessarily in need at the time, but joining together to love one another from across the state and across the region, and in particular, providing those basic needs that we need here in the 26th County region in East Texas Food Bank Services. So, again, my congratulations to the East Texas Food Bank and their leadership, to Captain Philpott. And when you said earlier, I had to smile about the cavalry coming in. This literally is the cavalry, the first squad of the 124th Cavalry Regiment. Captain Philpott and his group, we want to say thank you so much for all that your team has done while they've been here. And we hope that you are all blessed as you return back to your lives and your homes and your own hometowns going forward. And we hope that someday we can revisit this scenario and we can return this favor in some way. Again, congratulations. Thank you for service and sacrifice, both from the National Guardsmen and from the East Texas Food Bank. We bless each one.
Hello, my name is Jay Brooks. I'm the Fire Marshal Emergency Management Coordinator for Smith County. I'd like to echo those comments and just thank this unit for being here. This is a absolute blessing on this community, on Smith County and East Texas as a whole. The food bank, I just cannot, I'm just absolutely impressed with the operations. Had no idea before this disaster went on the magnitude and scale of what they do for our community, and I am just impressed and absolutely blessed to be a part, even a small part in this operation here. And through Judge Moran's leadership, I just want to thank Judge Moran. He is just doing a fantastic job. As the emergency management coordinator, my job is to coordinate his efforts during this disaster, because all disasters begin and end on a local level, even these on a worldwide scale. And so what you see here is a product of that leadership. When Mr. Cullinane came to us with a need, Judge Moran said, let's take care of that need. And so what you see is the product of a state of Texas assistant request. And so I'd like to also thank the governor and Chief Nim Kidd with the Texas Department of Emergency Management for their leadership and their approval of what you see before you today. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Captain Steve Philpott, and I'm the commander for the General Support Unit. Our soldiers are from the 1st Squadron, 124th Cavalry Regiment. We're comprised of soldiers from a diversity of skill sets, both in the military. We have HR specialists, medics, cavalrymen, infantry guys, but also on the civilian side. They live and work in communities all across Texas. These citizen soldiers are your neighbors, their fathers, their husbands, their students at our universities. They're deeply invested in keeping our fellow Texans safe. We're trained for this. This is kind of our bread and butter outside of any other federal mission is civil support. Many of these soldiers in front of you participated in Hurricane Harvey relief efforts. A lot of them also deployed in 2018 to a peacekeeping mission in Egypt. So they're happy to serve again. It's what we're trained to do, and it's what they love to do. We're honored to support the Smith County request and the East Texas Food Bank. To date, in the past 4 days, these guys have really knocked it out of the park. They have packed 117 pallets of food, which is roughly 223,000 meals. That's amazing. In just 4 days for them to get on the ground, get trained up by the East Texas Food Bank staff, and then just crank the number of meals out to support the citizens and the 26 counties that the food bank supports. It's absolutely an honor for me as a commander to just see the guys and what they can do. At the end of the day, it's what our tag always says, our adjutant general, it's we are Texans serving Texas, and we're proud to serve the Smith County, the East Texas Food Bank, and the 26 counties that the East Texas Food Bank supports.
Thank you, Captain Philpott. And in closing, I'd just like to give you an update on so far all these boxes, these 20-pound boxes that are filled with a balance of nutritious foods. We've served 14,430 of those boxes so far. We've got quite a few that are on stock, ready to go to some negative distributions that we're going to be able to continue because of these efforts. In Tyler every week, we plan on returning down to Lufkin. We've got plans to open up distributions in Longview, in Texarkana, and Canton, and a couple other locations. Thanks to these efforts, these will make those possible. We're also serving over 32,000 households now at this particular time. We're serving meals. We've served 37,000 meals in on-site kitchens like homeless shelters. And I'd like to end by, we've given a lot of thanks, but I'd like to recap that, especially by thanking the troops, first of all, for being here, from your taking time in your regular lives, from your regular assignments to come to this mission to help support our mission, from being our hungry neighbors, people that have never thought that they would need help again, or ever need help. We're seeing new people come to these lines every day, and you're making a possibility to help feed their families through a difficult time. I want to thank Feeding America and Feeding Texas, two amazing organizations that we've been closely knit with and affiliated with, providing best practices, leadership, guidance, financial funding, food sources. It's endless. Advocacy. Feeding Texas has had a lot to do within our state of Texas and organizing food banks with the National Guard and through the Department of Emergency Management. We couldn't have done it without you. We're a strong organization, but we're always better together, and we are really knit into those programs. Locally, again, we'd like to thank especially Judge Moran and Jay Brooks for the quick response to our needs and to bringing your significant voice to the state of Texas and helping make this a reality. We'd also like to thank especially Kevin East and the Mentoring Alliance for coming to the rally so quickly with us, and the paid staff, the volunteers that they were able to marshal. They're still at work, even though that we really got the National Guard here during the day. We were able to use the Mentoring Alliance folks out in the TISD programs that we're operating. They're also helping us with some of those mega distributions at the state fair rallies. And I'd also like, I've been given a lot of credit, but it's not, there's nothing that, I don't deserve all the credit, or any of the credit, really. We've got a tremendous staff here at the East Texas Food Bank. Brian recognized Donna for her leadership, but especially Andrew Gayo in the operations team that you see here, have been here throughout and have been solid and have really made this operation hum. And this community would not be blessed without that core leadership that we've had here at the East Texas Food Bank. And last but not least, Lord not least, we would like to thank our amazing community of donors. We've had a significant number of people rise to the occasion and want to help in so many ways, with food, with funding, with volunteer efforts, getting